Mr. Eve Gallaire, agus Fáilte I've got Matt and Michael. Welcome to Trip. Behind me is the 6 metre high sculpture called King and Queen by the artist Ronan Halpin. It's on the Trim bypass and it was commissioned by Meath County Council as part of the Percent for Art scheme when the bypass was being built. It was erected in 1992. The artist was obviously inspired by nearby Tara, traditionally the seat of the High Kings of Ireland, and I suppose also by Trim Castle, which was visited by a King of England, King John, in 1210, though he didn't actually get into the castle and had to rest outside in tents. Richard II also came and he did stay in Trim Castle in 1399. I don't think any of the Queens of England visited Trim, but Prince Charles, who presumably will be the next King of England, did visit Butterstream Gardens in Trim in 1995. The sculptor Ronan Halpin was born in Drogheda in 1958 and he studied at the National College of Art and Design in Dublin and at the Yale School of Art in the United States. He has had many exhibitions across Ireland and abroad. These bronze sculptures are very impressive, but it does seem that the positioning isn't the best. Because of where they are, they don't really stand out, like many other similar sculptures do throughout the country. Also, the trees close by regularly threaten to cover them. Anyway, here's the king of Trim music, Matt.
If the student prince is not the most popular of the Romberg stage shows, it may be because it's a bit lopsided in terms of its cast. It's very male oriented, is the student prince, but his music is beautiful. And I'm going to attempt to sing some of the student prince, and I hope you will sing the bits that I'm missing in the middle. I swear my blossoms on the bough. Nothing is heard but the song of a bird, filling all the air with dreaming. Could this music last forever?
Marcella, our volunteer in the readings in Care Choice Trim, for introducing me to this with her reading in her lovely Tyrone accent. My accent isn't as nice as that, but I'll do my best. The shape I'm in. There's nothing the matter with me. I'm as healthy can be. I have arthritis in both knees, and when I talk with a wheeze. My pulse is weak, my blood is thin, but I'm awfully well for the shape I'm in. All my teeth have had to come out, and my diet I hate to think about. I'm overweight and I can't get thin, but I'm awfully well for the shape I'm in. Arch supports I need for my feet, or I wouldn't be able to go out in the street. Sleep is denied me night after night, but every morning I find I'm all right. My memory's failing, my head's in a spin, but I'm awfully well for the shape I'm in. Old age is golden, I've heard it said, but sometimes I wonder as I go to bed. With my ears in a drawer, my teeth in a cup, and my glasses on a shelf until I get up. And when sleep thins my eyes, I say to myself, is there anything else I should lay on the shelf? The reason I know my youth has been spent is my get up and go has got up and went. But really, I don't mind when I think with a grin of all the places my get-up has been. I get up each morning and dust off my wits, pick up the paper and read the obits. If my name is missing, I'm therefore not dead, so I eat a good breakfast and jump back to bed. The moral of this, as the tale unfolds, is that for you and me who are growing old, it's better to say, I'm fine, with a grin, than to let people know the shape you're in.
L.S. Lowry was born in the north of England in Manchester, and I think it was 1887. His notes suggest that he wasn't a popular lad at all. He was a kind of an oddity, I think, and had strange relationships with his parents. It transpires like that so many people like him. His genius made him different. And it's difficult to cope with reality with strong differences. Anyway, he became renowned as an artist, but not, I think, in his own lifetime. He wasn't born into the ascendancy or the aristocracy. He was the son of ordinary working class people. And most of his artistic works are around the Lancashire mills and all that, where he actually worked. And this song As nice memories for me. I don't know what I was doing the other day when it crossed my mind. But I have a creator, did you ever get a nice memory frozen in time in your mind? I have one such memory of this, and it involves this song. Many years ago, when we lived in the country, many years ago, when my brother and his family were visiting on one occasion, I remember just before they left for home, the kids got in the corner of the room and they sang this song. And it remained indelibly imprinted in my mind, as nice memories tend to do. And that creates in my mind a hope that my song, this song particularly, and another one that I did a while ago, about Gilly Gilly, Oss and Pepper, Castanet and Bogan by the Sea, I have mental images of kids singing those songs, playing my video and learning and singing the songs along with me. That would make my day. And it would make my day even more if somebody would send me a video of their kids and grandchildren learning to sing along with my songs. That would be just the icing on the cake. So anyway, I think I better swap my hat for my cap, as the words suggest. Now, Lowry was born in Manchester, so people will be expecting the song to be sung in Mancunian, so to speak. Well, I'll do my best. I just noticed a word of explanation here. The chorus has the expression sparking clogs. Now, I don't know what sparking clogs would be, but I can guess. After the war, men's boots were manufactured with a steel tip on the heel. In fact, they became known as tips. And boys and young men all loved to get boots with tips on them. Great for sliding down the hill or streets on a winter's day. And I think that's probably what a sparking clog is meant to be. So here we go. He painted sulphur smoky tops and cardboard boxes from the shops and parts of band courts where I used to play. I'm sure he once walked down our street, 'cause he painted kids who would knout on their feet. The clothes he wore were all of better days. Now they said his works of art were dull, no room all round that walls were full, but Larry didn't care much anyway. They said he just paints cats and dogs, and matchstock men and boots and clubs, and Larry said that's just the way they'll stay. And he painted matchstock men and matchstock cats and dogs. He painted kids on the corner of the street and sparking clogs. Now he takes his push and he waits outside the factory gates to paint the matchstock men and matchstock cats and dogs. Now canvas and brushes were wearing thin when London started calling him to come on down and wear the old flat cap. Said, tell us all about your ways and all about them sulphur days. Is it true you're just an ordinary chap? And he painted matchstock men and matchstock cats and dogs. He painted kids on the corner of the street with his sparking clogs. Now he takes his brush and he waits outside the factory gates to
paint a matchstock pen and matchstock caps on drugs. Now Larry's hung upon the wall beside the greatest of them all, and even the Mona Lisa takes a bow. This tired old man with hair like snow tells northern folks it's time to go. The fever came and the good Lord mopped his brow. And he painted matchstock men and matchstock cats and dogs. He painted kids at the corner of the streets and his barking dogs. Now he takes his brush and he waits outside the pearly gates to paint his matchstock men and matchstock cats and dogs. And he painted matchstock men and matchstock cats and dogs. He painted kids on the corner of the street and his barking dogs. Now he takes his brush and he waits outside the pearly gates. Play his matchstock men and matchstock cats and dogs. And he painted matchstock men and matchstock cats and dogs. He painted kids on the corner of the street with sparking dogs. Now he takes his brush and he waits outside the pearly gates to paint his matchstock men and matchstock cats and dogs.
Taste of the goodness we're rich in.
One of the things you notice as you drive along the country roads is the amount of roadkill, the number of animals dead on the roadside. And this poem of mine came from that experience. Road victim. Though the badger looked alive, his stance was too static, frozen in death. Another roadside victim. I had often planned to stop beside each discarded carcass, hedgehog, badger, fox, rabbit, take home remains to freeze until I mastered taxidermy, then spend each evening rebuilding bodywork, repairing each break and tear, posing each, reshaped and lifelike on polished oak, to answer stares, alert, defiant, lifeless. I never took the course and have become resigned to leave each broken victim where it lies alone.
Inch by inch, row by row, gonna make this garden grow. All it takes is a rake and a hoe and a piece of fertile ground. Inch by inch, row by row, someone bless these seeds I sow. Someone warm them from below till the rain comes tumbling down. Pulling weeds, picking stones, man is made of dreams and bones. Feel the need to grow my own, cause the time is close at hand. Rainfall, rain, sun and rain, find my way in nature's chain. Tune my body and my brain to the music from this land. Up together now, inch by inch, row by row, gonna make this garden grow. All it takes is a rake and a hoe and a piece of fertile ground. inch by inch, row by row. Someone blessed these seeds I sow. Someone warmed them from below till the rain comes tumbling down. Plant your rows straight and long. Temper them with prayer and song. Old Mother Earth will make you strong if you give her love and care. Old Crow watching hungrily from his perch in yonder tree. In my garden I'm as free as that feathered thief up there.
Great to hear the original Matt and Michael. That's Matt with the late Michael Meegan from their Belinter CD. A special thanks also to one of our most loyal viewers for that video of their colourful garden. Lovely use of lots of containers. How is your garden looking? We'll finish this week with another song from the evergreen Kevin Byrne. This time it's Just a Wearying for You. An American song, much recorded. The lyrics were written by Frank Stanton and first published in 1894. Remember to subscribe to our YouTube channel to get notifications of new videos. Until the next M&M in 2 weeks' time, take care and God bless.
Just a wearying for you. All the time I'm feeling blue, wishing for you, wondering when you'll be coming home again. Restless, don't know what to do. Just a weary for you. Morning comes, the birds awake, seem to sing so for your sake. But there's sadness in the notes that comes thrilling from their throats. Seem to feed your sadness too. Just a weary for you. Evening comes, I miss you more, when the dark glooms round the door. Seems just like you ought to be here to open it for me. That ghost tinkling thrills me through, sets me wearying.